the second. Manasa Marbles Limited is manufacturing. Is a manufacturing company, and the following information has been obtained for the year ending 31st December 2010. Items beginning 1/1/10 and 31st December 10. Raw materials rupees 40,000, then 44,480. Work in progress 9,632,000. Finished products units given here 2,000, 4,000. Purchase of raw materials 2,40,000. Works manager salary 16,000. Indirect material 12,000. Indirect wage 2,000. Research and experiment cost 10,000. Employee state insurance 2,000. Other factory expenses 22,000. Direct wages 2,00,000. Carriage inward 2,880. Printing and stationery 4,000. Office salary 24,000. Counting of salary 4,000. Sales 6,00,000. Advertising discount allowed and selling cost is rupee 1 per unit sold. Total units produced is 32,000. Prepare a statement showing the cost and profit of Manasa Marbles Limited. So here the output is clearly given. Total units produced in the year is 32,000. So while preparing the cost sheet, say first of all you have to write the title or the name of the company, Manasa Marbles Limited, cost sheet for the year ending 31st December 2020, then 20 or 10. Then you have to take or you have to calculate the output or the goods produced during the year or units produced during the year. That is very important because we have to consider units and we have to calculate the unit cost. So for that purpose, number of units produced during the year in that particular accounting year is very important. Here it is given 32,000, so we need not calculate. So units here 32,000. So units means here units produced during the accounting period 32,000. So this starts with elements of cost here, columns here. We write elements of cost, elements of cost, then units, then total cost, then cost per unit, cost per unit. So these are the important columns. So it starts with the direct materials. While calculating the direct materials, we calculate the direct materials consumed during the year. Direct materials consumed during the year is nothing but opening stock of raw material plus purchase during the year less closing stock of raw material. Again here, carriage inward, carriage incurred while purchasing the goods has to be added. So this is how the material consumed is calculated. So direct materials, first item is direct materials. So while calculating the direct materials, we take opening stock. Here opening stock is 40,000. 40,000 rupees. Then purchases, add purchases. Purchased during the year 2,40,000. Then plus carriage inward. Carriage inward. It is 2,808. So these are added. So after adding this, 2,82,880. Less closing stock. Closing stock of raw material, it is 408. So after this we will get the net materials consumed during the year. So net materials consumed during the year is total is 238,400. Number of units 32,000 units. Now the unit cost. Unit cost is nothing but total cost divided by number of units. So it is 745, 7 rupees 45. Then to this we add direct wage. Direct wage. Here direct wage is 2 lakhs. So per unit direct wage is 6 rupees 25 paise. So units same, once we have written 30,000, no need of writing it again and again. 30,000. Now therefore prime cost. Prime cost. So total is 4,38,400. This is 13.70. Now factory overheads. To this we add factory overheads. Factory overheads one here. All the factory overheads. Indirect material. It is given. Indirect material is a factory overhead. Indirect material. It is 12,000. You take inner column. 12,000. Works manager salary. Works manager's salary. It is 16,000. Then indirect wage. Indirect wage 2,000. Then research and experiment. Research and experiment is a factory expenditure, 10,000. Then employees state insurance, ESI, it is a factory overhead, 2,000. Then other factory expenses, other factory expenses, total 22,000. So adding all these, we will get the total factory overheads. Total factory overheads is 64,000. 64,000. 2 rupees. Or here we can adjust. We can write here itself 64,000. We add or deduct, add opening stock of work in process, add opening work in progress. Opening work in progress is 9,600. Now the total is 5 lakh. Sorry, now the total is 73,600. From this less closing work in progress. Closing work in progress is 32,000. The net is 73,000 minus 32,000. So 71, then 41,600. So 41,600. Its cost per unit 41,600 divided by 32,000 is equal to 4,38,400 plus 41,600 is equal to 4,80,000. It is 4,80,000 divided by 32,000 is equal to 15 rupees. Then that it is 41,600 divided by 32,000 is equal to 1.30. So the answer is known as, after adjusting all the factory overheads, the answer is known as works cost. Therefore, Works cost total is 480,000. It is 15 rupees. To this we add administration overhead. So all the administration expenses. So one is here printing and stationery. Here given printing and stationery is 4,000. Write it inner side. Then office salary, it is 24,000. Counting house salary. Counting house salary is 4,000. So 24,000 plus 8,000 is equal to 32,000. Its unit cost is rupee 1. Now we adjust opening stock of finished goods plus opening stock of finished goods. So in this problem, opening stock of finished goods, units given 2000 units. Opening stock of finished goods 2000. You write here 2000. Then value is not given. If the value is not given, we have to value it on the basis of current rate. See, current rate per unit is 15 plus 1 is 16. So 2000 units into 16 rupees, you will get the value of the opening stock of finished goods. So it is now 480,000 plus 32,000 is equal to 512,060. So value here is 32,000. We got it. So here you need not include this because it is 16 rupees. Now after adding this here 32,000 plus 2,000 means 34,000. 512,000 plus 32,000 means 544,000. 44,000 here 16 rupees. Now less closing stock of what finished goods. About closing stock of finished goods, here the units, number of units, it is 4,000. So right here 4,000 units. Now the value is given, that value, otherwise we have to calculate the value. So value is equal to 4,000 into 16 rupees. 4,000 into 16 rupees. So it is again 64,000. Here we don't write it because the same rate 16. Now the value up 34,000 minus 4,000 means here 30,000. 544,000 minus 64,000 means here 480,000. The value is 16 rupees. This is known as cost of goods sold or the total cost. Cost of goods produced. This is. To this we add selling and distribution expenses. The various selling and distribution expenses, about this Advertisement discount allowed and selling cost is rupee 1 per unit sold. Selling and distribution expenses rupee 1 per goods sold. So how many units are sold here? 30,000 units are sold here. So 30,000 units into rupee 1 is equal to 30,000. 30,000. Then unit cost is 1 rupee. So now the total cost, therefore total cost 30,000 units sold, 4,80,000 plus 30,000 means here 5,10,000. This is 17 rupees. Now about the profit or the sales. Here sales are given. So you write the sales. Sales, how much? 30,000 units. 30,000 units. Then its total cost is 6 lakh. Unit selling price is 20 rupees. 20 rupees. This is the total cost. 5,10,000, 70 rupees. This is the sales. That is 30,000 units sold, 6 lakh at a rate of rupee 20. So total or the sales minus total cost is equal to profit. Therefore, profit here is 5,10,000 minus or 6 lakh minus 5,10,000 means here 90,000. So 20 minus 17 means 3 rupees. So this is the profit and this is the profit per unit. So this is how a cost sheet is prepared.